want to welcome you today, Between Two Trees. We have our first guest speaker ever, Judah River John. We've got a few questions for you today, Judah. Do you mind answering these questions? You do mind? Oh, perfect. First question we have for you is, what's one thing that has surprised you? Mommy surprised you?
No,
Jesus surprised you?
Yeah.
How did he surprise you? With chocolate?
Yeah.
I thought so. Now, Judah, do you know the Christmas story by chance?
Yeah.
Can you tell me anything about this story? What happens? What happens?
Turn right.
You turn right?
Yeah.
Are you talking about when Mary and Joseph were on the donkey?
Yeah.
And then they had to turn right?
Yeah.
Do you remember what they went into?
Yeah.
What was it?
A farm.
A farm?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What was in the farm?
Donkey, sheep, chickens.
Now, Judah, tell me about the way in which Jesus, before he was born, Mary and Joseph, how did they get to the barn? Because there's some controversy. Do you know how they got there?
Yeah.
What did they ride?
Tiger.
A tractor?
No.
No?
Tiger.
A tiger?
Yeah.
Where did you learn that he rode a tiger?
Daddy.
Was it Daddy as a tiger? I don't know what you're talking about. Do you have any songs you'd like to sing for us today? Judah, thank you for joining us, Between Two Trees. What's that? No way. This just in, we just acquired a bunch more special guests that are going to go further into telling us this Christmas story. So let's cut to...
What's a big surprise you've had before? Have you ever been surprised by something?
All my friends stumbled over to my birthday. That's a big present.
And what, did they say surprise?
Yeah.
Surprise!
Tell me about the big surprise that God did on Christmas.
Mary, Joseph, Jesus.
What would you do if you saw an
angel? Pray to God.
Have you ever had a big surprise? Like on your birthday? Or...
When I woke up and on my birthday was, I saw this, it's a big balloon that had ninja stickers all over.
What was your face like when you saw it? What did you ask for Christmas?
I asked for this flipping tiger car, so it's a remote control tiger car.
Wait.
It flips and it walks and its tires grip the stairs so it can walk up the stairs.
What about you, Kenzie? What did you ask for Christmas? Do you remember?
A teddy bear.
A teddy bear? So how do you think you would feel on Christmas if you opened up a present and that's what was inside? Can you tell me any of the parts of the Christmas story? What do you think Mary, how do you think Mary felt when she found out she was going to have a baby?
Surprised.
An angel came to visit
Mary and Joseph to tell them about they're going to have a baby.
What do you think Mary's face was like when the angel told her? What do you think Joseph's face was like when he found out? And when they got to Bethlehem, could they stay at like a hotel?
No, because the hotel was so full that they couldn't stay. They went to a stable.
What kind of song do you think he'd sing for Jesus if he saw him for the first time?
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, I wonder what you are. Up, up, up the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle.
That was so beautiful. You have such a nice singing voice.
Thank you.
So all the inns are full, so they go to the, it's like a
stable.
Okay. They go to the stable and they stay there with all the animals.
What kind of animals live in a barn?
A fox?
A fox? I love foxes.
A lot of foxes. Okay. Apparently it's a fox barn.
What else happens in the Christmas story? Are there anything in the sky?
A shooting star!
A shooting lion!
And what happened next was they arrived, like Mary, Joseph, and the little one inside, and the donkey. They all arrived. They went house to house, and they all said there was no room for anyone to stay and have a baby.
So far away from the happening were these three shepherds watching their sheep, and then all of the angels came and started singing and dancing for some reason.
And Joseph was definitely surprised. He was gonna be a father of a king, and he wasn't even close to being a king. But after he had that baby, he was pretty close because his son was a king.
I didn't know about that, but it would take a long time.
Do you remember how it starts?
Mary, I was riding the donkey.
Why was she riding the donkey?
Because she was going to Bethlehem.
What was in Bethlehem?
No bed for them.
No
so
bed.
They knocked on the different door and they said they had a manger bed for them. But then there was a monster, but Joseph killed it. It was huge. It was dead because he wasn't being very nice. But it was just a small baby monster. He didn't grow. But God went closer to him, and then the baby monster just kissed Jesus. Then the Grinch decided to go over and eat with them. That's what they did. It's God's birthday today.
Can you say happy birthday, Jesus?
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
I did not say it. I was not ready.
Okay, you ready? 3, 2, 1.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Wasn't that cute? I love those kids. We're actually gonna now watch that story unfold. Stay tuned.
Have you ever wondered what we might see if we could pull back the curtain of time to that very first Christmas? If we could, I imagine it would look something like this. The story began in heaven. God was looking over heaven's balcony, shaking his head at the wrong things people were doing. Then he looked at the stars, smiled, and said,
"It's time."
"Time for what, Lord?"
"Time for my plan to rescue the earth. I feel so far away from my people down there. It's hard to be close to someone when you don't like what they're doing. So we're going to step in."
"Shall we bring in the army, Lord, and teach them a lesson?"
"No, I don't think we should send in an army. Maybe just one person."
"One person?
What?"
"Brent, they won't be expecting that."
Lord, if you're only going to send one person down there, they're going to have to be very powerful and strong.
Because there's lots of people down there.
No, they don't have to be very powerful or very strong. They'll be going as a newborn baby.
A newborn baby?
What?
Brent, don't be expecting that.
Lord, this plan is rather risky. A newborn human is small and weak.
This baby must be born to someone who will protect him, maybe a great ruler or mighty king.
Actually, I was thinking I could send him to a young peasant girl whose heart is beautiful and filled with faith.
A peasant girl?
Brent, don't be expecting that.
My lord, I see that your plan is to take Earth by surprise, but what good can a baby do?
This is not just any baby. I will be sending the Prince of Heaven in disguise.
Your son?
Brent, they won't be expecting that.
Lord, this is too risky. Sending the Prince of Heaven down in disguise as a tiny baby? Born not to kings, but to humble villagers.
Surely our prince cannot be born in a cottage, but in a palace.
You're right. He shouldn't be born in a cottage. He should be born in a stable.
A stable
filled with hay,
filled with excrement.
Blink, they won't be expecting that.
Lord, how will people know he's here? What if they don't notice?
Those who are looking for him will find him. His mission will bring all people closer to me, even if they do something really wrong. When the prince is done, nothing will get between them and my love.
Can we leave some clues for people looking, like in the stars?
Sure. We can make one big one that points to him.
Can we sing for him?
Yes, can we sing?
Sing to welcome him?
Please say we can sing.
God looked at their hopeful faces, and his heart was touched by their love for the prince.
All right, you can sing.
Yay!
But not to the whole world. That would just be weird. And no kings or rulers.
How about we sing for some shepherds? That's a lonely job. Maybe they need some cheering up.
Really, they won't be expecting that.
You know the rest of the story. An angel visited a humble girl with a courageous heart and told her the good news. She would have a baby, and he would be the Prince of Heaven, who would help Earth be close to God again. As planned, the baby was born in a stable, about as far from a palace as you can get. A group of wise men noticed some strange clues in the stars. They packed their belongings and followed the star right to a baby. And of course, a bunch of lonely shepherds were guarding their sheep when all of a sudden the sky was lit up by thousands of angels singing. Nobody would ever expect that.
Born unto us this day, the Savior. Gifted from heaven to a manger. The hope of the world's alive.